Safety rules and regulations that we know under the Hazard Communication Standard are now changing, including changes in the material safety data sheets, labels, and warning requirements. OSHA's Hazard Communication Standard, known as HazCom, will now integrate into the United Nations globally harmonized system of classification and labeling of chemicals. It will now be known as the Hazard Communication and Globally Harmonized System, or simply the GHS. The purpose of this video is to review the major changes that you're going to see. The GHS, or Globally Harmonized System, will now require chemical manufacturers to provide specific criteria to address health and physical hazards, as well as classification of chemical mixtures. Labels will be required to show much more information than before. For example, chemical manufacturers and importers must provide a label that includes a signal word, a pictogram, a hazard statement, and precautionary statement for each hazard class and category. What we now know as material safety data sheets are now going to be shortened in name and will be known simply as safety data sheets, or SDS, instead of MSDS. The safety data sheets, or SDS, will now have a new format that has 16 specific sections, ensuring consistency in presentation of important detection information. OSHA's Hazard Communication Standard is designed to ensure that information about chemical hazards and associated protective measures are disseminated to all workers. This standard has been revised to include the GHS. The major changes you should know right now are hazard classification. This replaces hazard determination. Hazard classification provides specific criteria for classification of health and physical hazards, as well as classification of mixtures. Labels. Chemical manufacturers and importers will be required to provide a label that includes a harmonized signal word, pictogram, and hazard statement for each hazard class and category. Safety data sheets will now have a specified 16-section format. In the new GHS, all chemicals will now be classified into three major hazard groupings. The first and the largest is physical hazards. This includes items like explosives, flammable gases and aerosols, flammable solids, gases under pressure, self-reactive substances that can react violently with water, and other solid substances that emit a flammable gas when wet, oxidizers like oxygen and hydrogen peroxide, and corrosives, which are either strong acids, strong bases, or concentrated solutions of certain weak acids or weak bases. They can exist as any state of matter, including liquids, solids, gases, mists, or vapors. The next major hazard group is health hazards. Examples of health hazards include acute toxicity. For example, hydrogen cyanide is a highly toxic substance. Acute exposure at relatively low doses can result in death. Skin corrosions or irritants can cause severe skin burns and/or eye damage. Another health hazard is serious eye damage or eye irritation, then respiratory or skin sensitization. Sensitizers can cause severe organ damage or major permanent functional changes in organ systems, for example, the lungs. Germ cell mutagenicity. These are chemicals which may cause mutations in the germ cells of humans, and then these mutations can be transmitted to offspring. Carcinogens. These are chemicals associated with causing cancers. Other toxic chemicals that affect the reproductive organs or other specific organs, and aspiration hazards. The third major hazard grouping is environmental hazards. This is new, and OSHA does not have jurisdiction over environmentally toxic chemicals. The labeling and SDS requirements under GHS require environmental labeling, but OSHA considers this portion of the standard non-mandatory, as environmental hazards are regulated by the EPA. Therefore, we will not be concerned with this area. It is being mentioned here for information purposes only. Let's talk about the Material Safety Data Sheet, or as we know it now, the old MSDS. The old MSDS has been found to be less useful in many circumstances because it did not contain enough information. The new Safety Data Sheets, or SDS, will replace the 9-part MSDS with a 16-part document. Although that sounds more complicated, you will find that much more information is being presented in a much better way. The SDS is product-related, and although it is not able to provide information that is specific for any given workplace where the product may be used, the expanded SDS information will include much more data funneled down into a better document to help us understand the chemicals we are using. The SDS will enable people to develop an active program of worker protection measures, including training that is specific to your individual workplace, and to consider any measures that may be necessary to protect the environment. Information in an SDS also provides a source of information for other workers, such as those involved with the transport of dangerous goods, emergency responders, poison centers, and finally, consumers. The new standardized SDS format will make finding hazard and chemical information on the SDS easier for both employers and employees. There is no set format to the Material Safety Data Sheet, and they can range in length from one page to 20 or more pages. The new Safety Data Sheet will contain only 16 headings. All SDS will be in this standard format, which will make it easier for all of us to find the information that we need for our workplace. The SDS headings, sequence, and content are similar to many of the items required by other regulatory organizations. Reviewing the headings gives you an idea of how comprehensive the information will be. In the new standardized format safety data sheets, the first thing that will be provided is an identification of the product or chemical. Next, the hazards within the product will be identified, and then the composition or other information will be provided about ingredients. First aid measures will be discussed, as well as fire fighting measures, and that will be followed by a section that discusses how to handle accidental releases. Handling and storage is the next category, and then the eighth category will discuss exposure control or your personal protection, what kind of PPE may be needed handling the product. Physical and chemical properties will be explained, followed by the stability and reactivity information, and then toxicological information. The next three sections, ecological information, disposal considerations, and transport information, are not required by OSHA, but may be included in the safety data sheet. And the last two sections will be regulatory information and then any other information deemed pertinent by the manufacturer or an outside regulatory agency. Here are the first two pages of a sample safety data sheet. Note the specific sections. All safety data sheets will have the sections or headings in this order and in this format. This will make finding specific information much easier. There is not a standard format for the GHS label. However, there are required label elements. The GHS label elements that you see here with an asterisk have been standardized and are directly related to the hazard level. The other label elements are defined based on common definitions. But these three elements, hazard pictograms, signal words, and hazard statements, are all hazard warnings and are required to be grouped together on the label. The symbols, signal words, and hazard statements have all been assigned to specific hazard categories and classes. On labels the GHS system uses, only two words, danger and warning, are used to inform the chemical user of the severity of the hazards of the chemical. The use of just two signal words is used to help simplify warnings and the labeling system. For example, thinking about the word danger, imagine yourself driving up to an intersection with a stop sign. This signals to the driver that this is a potentially dangerous intersection and that the driver is required to stop and look before proceeding through the intersection. If the signal word on a label is danger, the chemical user should understand that this is a highly hazardous chemical and they should stop and become familiar with all the characteristics of the product before proceeding. On the other hand, if the label contains the word warning, This is like driving up to an intersection controlled by a yield sign. The driver can proceed through the intersection with caution, as it also has the potential to be a hazardous intersection. However, labels that contain the signal word warning indicates that the severity of hazards of the chemicals are less than those chemicals classified with the signal word danger. Hazard statements are supposed to give the chemical user additional information about the hazard that is depicted in the pictogram. For example, if you saw the flame pictogram on a label for a flammable liquid, the hazard statement might be, keep away from fire, sparks, and heated surfaces. As stated earlier, hazard statements have been standardized and the chemical manufacturer, importer, or distributor is responsible for using the appropriate hazard statement or statements on the label. The other statements shown are more examples of standardized hazard statements. Pictograms are now required. Only 8 are required by OSHA, but a 9th may also be used to indicate environmental hazards. The labels for hazardous chemicals must contain one or more of the pictograms to illustrate the hazards of the chemical. The exclamation mark pictogram, when shown by itself on a label, is for chemicals that have toxicity levels that are harmful to humans but are not usually fatal. This includes chemicals that can be irritants to skin and eyes. For example, pepper spray is a skin and eye irritant, and many soaps, detergents, and cleaning products like ammonia and chlorine can be irritants. The exclamation mark pictogram will also be used to show skin sensitizers, acute toxicity, narcotic effects, respiratory tract irritants, also something that could be hazardous to the ozone layer. However, this would not be mandatory under OSHA. While the chemical hazards associated with the exclamation mark pictogram are a concern and precautions need to be taken, they are not as dangerous as the health effects or hazards associated with the health hazard pictogram. Health hazard means a chemical that can cause acute or chronic health effects in exposed personnel. Chemicals like gasoline, benzene, acetone, and products like brake cleaner or anything containing volatile organic compounds will have the health hazard pictogram on the label. When you see the health hazard pictogram, the product or chemical will fall under the list of potential health hazards, including the group mentioned earlier. The flame pictogram indicates the product or chemical has flammable or self-reactive characteristics or other hazards as listed here. This is the pictogram for all gases under pressure. Don't be fooled by the picture of the cylinder because it covers much more. This symbol includes all cylinders, propane tanks, natural gas tanks, refrigerated liquids, and many other products in this category. The chemical hazards associated with the corrosion pictogram are skin corrosives and can cause permanent eye and skin damage. This symbol, one that is seen commonly in the military, is one we don't see very often in private industry, unless of course you handle ammunition, explosives, and so on. Oxidizers are symbolized by an O with flames on top of the O. The skull and crossbones pictogram is for chemicals with acute toxicity effects that are deadly and could lead to fatality if not handled correctly. The dead fish and trees symbol signals environmental information. This is non-mandatory under the OSHA standard, as OSHA does not regulate environmental hazards. As we said before, the EPA regulates environmental hazards, and the chemical manufacturer, importer, or distributor would be required to comply with EPA regulations in addition to the OSHA labeling requirements. Here is an example of the labels you may see under the new GHS rules. As stated earlier in this presentation, there is no standard format required for the GHS label, so the information may or may not be in the order presented here. In fact, you can anticipate that most labels will look different from each other. The thing you need to keep in mind is that even though labels will look different, the information they will be required to list on the label is the same, and you should understand how to read and use the data presented. Other items required to be on GHS labels include precautionary statements. These are phrases that describe recommended measures that should be taken to minimize or prevent adverse effects resulting from exposure to a hazardous chemical or improper storage or handling. The precautionary statements would be the same on the label and on the safety data sheet for the product. The product identifier. This is how the hazardous chemical is identified. This can be, but is not limited to, the chemical name, code number, or batch number. The manufacturer, importer, or distributor can decide the appropriate product identifier. The same product identifier must be both on the label and in Section 1 of the safety data sheet. The supplier identification. The name, address, and telephone number must be provided on the label. You may also see statements pertaining to any pertinent supplemental information. This could be information added at the discretion of the manufacturer or distributor, or it might be information required by another regulatory agency. If a chemical manufacturer, importer, or distributor becomes aware of a new hazard for a chemical they produce, they have 3 months to update the label and the safety data sheet for that product or chemical. For example, if new research finds that a product was recently found to be carcinogenic, the chemical manufacturer, importer, and/or distributor will have 3 months from the time they are aware of the carcinogen health hazard to change the label and safety data sheet for the chemical to include the new health hazard carcinogen information. This presentation summarizes major modifications of the Hazard Communication Standard to the globally harmonized system. We are exposed to chemicals and chemical products every day. You can find them in your workplace, your home, in schools, hospitals, hotels, just about everywhere. Exposure to hazardous chemicals is one of the major hazards in the workplace. Knowing how to find and understand information on the chemicals around you will help protect you, your coworkers, and your families. Thanks for watching, and have a safe day.